Residency, Koti, Hyderabad. The residency complex occupies a good 60 acres of prime land at Chadargat. It was placed in the midst of an expensive park, pleasant orchards and flower beds. The residency was designed and constructed by late Samuel Russell of the Royal Engineers Madras between 1803 and 1807. The entire construction work was executed by Indian workmen under the supervision of a prominent civil contractor of the day, Veerasamy Mudaliar, the father of the famous Raja Kundaswamy. A flight of 22 stone steps leads to a 60x26 feet portico with Corinthian pillars of 50 feet height. The grand reception room or the Darbar Hall is 60 feet long, 33 feet wide and 50 feet high, with a balcony above it and two oval drawing rooms on either sides, besides a library and billiard room, etc. The house was furnished with most expensive Georgian furniture from Carlton House of the Prince Regent, William carpets, splendid chandeliers, by blade huge mirrors, rare marble sculptures, paintings and rich hangings. Even the resident Metcalfe, who noted with shudder that the chairs had cost £50 apiece, expressed his admiration for the furniture, which was superb beyond any I ever saw. There are reasons to believe that some of these art treasures found their way to Sala Jung's collection. It was oriental in its magnificence, remarked Sir James McIntosh in 1808, but perfectly English in its comforts. It was only surpassed in splendor and magnitude, wrote Sir Joe Malcolm, who he saw it in 1817 by the Government House at Calcutta. The residency was constructed at the expense of the Nizam. The second Nizam, Nizam Ali Khan, sanctioned the permission for construction in 1799 as a special favor to the sixth resident, James Achilles Kilpatrick, 1797-1805, who was the only envoy among the long list to have the distinction of representing both the governments. The Nizam treated him as his own son, addressing him Farzanda Mohabbat Pehwana. The Nizam bestowed on him by special sanat a series of grandiloquent titles like Hazmat Jani. He was even permitted to consummate his romantic alliance with a Muslim noble lady of Persian extract by name Khairunisa Begum. Befitting his own dignity, the Nizam, to oblige his affectionate son, raised a stunningly wonderful palace, which was described by the celebrated character Amir Ali Tang as a magnificent mansion. Never before or after, from the beginning to the end of their dynasty, none of the Nizams ever built another splendid edifice as the residency, even for their own royal selves. The southern or the back gateway of the residency overlooks the northern gateway of the walled city of Hyderabad across the river. The former, known as Triumphal Arch of Empress Gate, supported by lofty Doric columns, was the ceremonial gateway.